Hello friends, so today we'll discuss paper 1, which was conducted in June 2019 by NTA. So paper 1 is basically a general paper, no subject oriented questions are there, just logical reasoning aptitude is tested here. You can subscribe to our channel for more videos which will definitely help those students who will be giving exam in December. So starting with this paper. So question 1 here is, from the following list identify the qualitative research characteristics. We know the qualitative research characteristics does not include numericals, does not include statistical analysis, because it is not a type of quantitative analysis, it is a qualitative research. So stating the purpose research question in a broad way, collecting data based on words from a small number of individuals. Collecting numeric data is not there. Creating purpose statement research questions is also not there. Using text analysis and interpreting larger meanings of the findings, basically generalizing that what you have found. So, 5. So, the correct option here is 2, 3 and 5, which is option number 1. Now, question number 2, what are the elements of evaluation plan? So, we know that evaluation plan is basically to evaluate something. So, sooner the evaluation plan is made by a firm, by an organization, better it is to implement processes afterwards. So for that we need purpose, we need the resources, we need the analysis, but authority is not required to prepare the evaluation plan. So the correct option here is option number 4, which includes purpose, resources and analysis. Now we have instructions which encourage live participation. Note here, live participation has been asked here. Live participation and interaction through online classes are called. Synchronous instructions is the correct answer. Why not asynchronous instructions? Asynchronous instructions also is related to the online teaching. But here it means the web-based teaching or the web-based teaching or the e-learning, which does not have the live participation of the students and the teachers. But in synchronous instructions there is live participation, and the question here asks us the live participation and interaction. So the correct answer is option number 1. Now which of the following is a key behavior contributing to effective teaching? So what, how is effective teaching done? By explaining the concepts and the logical step-by-step presentation so that a student could understand each and everything correctly and with appropriate knowledge is enhanced, is engulfed by the individual. So option number 4 is correct. Now option 5, question 5, which type of evaluation focuses on the identification of deficiencies and difficulties of the learner? Diagnostic evaluation is the correct answer, because diagnostic evaluation means to diagnose the deficiencies and difficulties in a learner. Whereas follow-up evaluation is basically some predetermined set goals were there and some actual things are done. So just to compare the actual things which is done with the predetermined set goals. So this is not the correct answer. So diagnostic evaluation is the correct answer, because it is here to diagnose the deficiencies and the difficulties. Then we have question 6. What is position papers? So let me tell you that what position papers exactly is. Position papers are the point of view papers. So when someone is writing a paper that is a position paper, he writes point of his own point of view, highlighting issues and depictions of the status. So the option 4, which is highlighting of issues and depiction of status, is the correct answer here. Now, which of the following is an example of higher order cognitive learning outcome? Here, higher order has been asked. So, learning of concepts and the abstractions is the correct answer. Tertiary sources of data includes primary and secondary sources. So, the option 3 is correct. Now, question 9 is a hypothesis. Hypothesis is used by a researcher in his research work. What hypothesis is? It is basically a tentative statement which a researcher wishes to explain, which wishes to prove so that it helps in his research work. What he is trying to prove is being formalized, is being transformed into a tentative statement, and which is called a hypothesis. Now, question 10, case studies. So, case studies is basically the in-depth examination or analysis of a particular topic, of a particular subject, and then the 360 degree analysis around that topic is being done in case study. So, in-depth examination of a subject and its related conditions. So, that is option number 2 is correct answer. Now, this is a comprehension question, and 4 or 5 questions are then followed up from this comprehension. So we'll read this. The main points here are that during 1970s, the negative liberty, which is the freedom from external restraints, was there. Then there was a shift from negative to the positive freedom. Positive freedom means a freedom from pursuit of some predetermined goals. Now this whole comprehension, the crux of this comprehension is the social responsibility, which has been now transformed from the negative freedom to social responsibility, or basically the positive freedom. Now, here it has also been observed that social responsibility to be only slightly disguised version of authoritarianism. And some well-intentioned attempts are being made by outside groups seeking media improvement are self-serving. So now let's see the questions. According to John Merrill, seeking improvement in media is, we have already seen, even well-intentioned attempts by outside groups seeking media improvement are self-serving. So the correct answer is self-serving, which is option number 4. Now, what are the basis of the operation of journalists earlier? So earlier, the journalists were determined to negative liberty, which means freedom from external restraint. So the here, the options are freedom of limited choices, free from outside pressure, social responsibility and government control. So the correct answer is option number 3, which is free from outside pressures. Now, question number 13, the passage critically analyzes the social responsibility theory of media. Throughout this comprehension, throughout this passage, only the social responsibility theory of media has been discussed and critically analyzed. Now, question number 14, positive freedom means, we have seen here that positive freedom is a freedom from pursuit of some predetermined goals. So, option number 2, pursuing certain set goals, is the correct answer. Question number 15, some scholars consider social responsibility aspect of media as authoritarianism, is the correct answer. Here we can see slightly disguised version of authoritarianism. Now, communication through colors can result in, communication can be verbal, can be non-verbal, can be communication could be through the colors. So, aesthetic codes, cultural codes, semantic codes and binary codes are the options given here. So, the correct answer would be aesthetic codes. Aesthetic codes is basically the art or paintings or drawings aesthetically, or the cultural codes. Some culture wishes to have black color, some culture. So basically cultural codes are also there. So it is basically an implicit, or the communication through colors is basically a thing which is there in that. So basically aesthetic codes and cultural codes would be the correct answer. So option number 4 here is the correct answer. Now, identify the reasoning in the following arguments. A pilot without flight plans is like an artist without paints. So basically, when two things have been compared, one thing has been depicted through another thing. So that is basically analogical in nature. So option 1, analogical, is the correct answer. Now, question 18, assertion here is media entertainment does not enhance the cultural level of society. Reason here given is most media entertainment encourages escapism and not content quality. So, assertion is correct, and the reason which is given here is the correct explanation for the given assertion. So, option 1 is correct here. Now, question number 19, in which method of arriving at knowledge the emphasis on both proceeding from particular to general and from general to particular in a combined way? We know inductive method is from particular to general. We know deductive method is general to particular. We know analogical method is basically finding the similarity, that this is like this, as we have seen in the previous question discussed above. So the scientific method is the correct answer, which has been given by NTA. So option number 3 is the correct answer. Now, in the communication process, signs derive meanings through the network of interrelation. As there is network of interrelation, people are connected through each other. So, there is network of interrelations. So, signs have been derived from there. Now, here it has been asked that 10% in all sales up to Rs. 10,000 commission, then 5% in all sales exceeding this, and Manoj remits Rs. 75,500 to his company after deducting the commission. So now here we have to find the total sales. We can say total sales to be X. We can say that total sales is comprised of the commission and the sales without commission. So the commission here is 0.10x, 0.10 into 10,000, which is the sales. So here, because it is given 10% all sales, that is 1,000. Plus, we have been given 5% all sales exceeding this. That means X minus 10,000. So 0.05 X minus 10,000 plus 75,500 is equals to X, your total sales. So solving for X, we get X is equals to 80,000. So option 2 is the correct answer. Question 22. Given below are two premises with four conclusions drawn from them. So first, this is all cats are dogs, and second, all dogs are cows. So by using the Venn diagram, we will see the answer here. All cats are dogs. So cats, dogs. All cats are dogs and all dogs are cows. So the conclusions here are all cats are cows. We can see yes. Some cows are cats. Yes. All dogs are cats. No. No cow is dog. No. So only A and B are true. So the option number 3 is correct here. Question 23. In a bag, there are coins of 5 paisa, 10 paisa, 25 paisa in the ratio of 3 is to 2 is to 1. And if there are rupees 60 in all, then how many 5 paisa coins are there? How many 5 paisa coins are there is the question which to which we have to find the answer. So here we can say simply 5, 10, 25 paisa into 3, because the proportion given here is 3 into 2 into 1. So 15, 20 and 25, the answer is 60 paisa. Now we have to find in 60 rupees. So if in 60 paisa there are 3 5 paisa coins, 3 5 paisa coins, so in 60 rupees there would be 3 into 100 5 paisa coins, which is 300 coins. So option 3 is the correct answer. Now, question 24, language of communication also constitutes the social world is the correct answer. The sum of all even natural numbers between 1 and 81 is, so we can find this through arithmetic progression. So, finding n, we have to find the n. So, l is equals to a plus n minus 1 d. D is the difference between everything. So 2 plus 4 plus 6 so on till 80. Between 1 and 81 it is given. So L would be 80. A is the smallest number 2. N minus 1. D is the difference, which is 2. Finding n, we have 40. Now we have to find the sum. So sum is basically n by 2 A plus L. So sum will come out to be 1640. 40 by 2, 2 plus 80. Now, missing term out of the given alternative, the next question is question number 26. Here the in reverse order, everything is given: QPO, NML, KJI, and then the reverse order. Going through this order, we have HGF. So the correct answer is option 1. Now if the proposition some milk is curd is taken to be true, then which of the following propositions can be false? So the answer given by NTA is no milk is curd, which is option number 1. Now the simple interest on a certain sum of money for 3 years. So we have here, we have to equate simple interest with the compound interest to find out the amount invested in simple interest. So P into R into T is the formula for simple interest. For compound interest, the formula is principal into 1 plus r raised to power n. Here we can say like this nt, but here as it is per annum, so this doesn't matter because it anyway has to be 1. So we have to find this, so we'll take it at x into 0.04 into 3 is equals to half, because it is half the compound interest. So 2000 into 1.102. So solving for x, we get the answer as 1750. Option 2 is the correct answer. Now, question number 29, the proposition some trees are green is equivalent to which of the following propositions? So all of these propositions are true. Many trees are green, some green things are trees, some green things are not non-trees, and trees are usually green. So the answer given by NTA here is option number 1. Now, question 30, connotative communication inside the classroom is, connotation is basically giving a symbol or connote something, to connote something, to abbreviate something. So it is basically implied in nature. So it is implicit in nature, which is option number 3. Now here, DI has been given. Now 3 or 4 questions is based on this illustration here. So for total 45,000 laptops have been sold during these 6 months, April, May, June, July, August, September. The data is given. Now sale of laptops month-wise is given, and the ratio of each month is given. So we have H stands for HP and D stands for Dell. So the first question we see is that if 35% of the laptops sold of brand H during August were sold at a discount, then how many laptops of brand H during that month were sold without a discount? So we have 45,000 into, we have to find brand H August. So August, in August 12%, 0.12, then we have to find the ratio of the H, that is HP in August, which is 7 by 15. So the answer would be 2520, and of this 2520, 0.35 and 0.65 is there. 0.35 is with discount and this is without discount. So 2520 into 0.65 will give us the answer 1638. So option number 3 is the correct answer. Now another question, 32, what is the total number of laptops sold of brand D during May and June? So during May it is 45,000 into 0.22 into, we have to find of brand D. So 5 by 9, which comes out to 5500. Then another is 45,000 for June. This is for June and that was for May. We have to add it. So 45,000 into 0.25 into, for June it is 2 by 5, so this comes out to 4500. So 5500 plus 4500 is 10,000. So option 2 is the correct answer. Then we have been given the profit 434 on each laptop of brand D during July. So what we'll do is we'll find the units which was sold in July of brand D, and we'll multiply the unit number of units with the profit of each unit. So we'll get the answer. So number of units will be 45,000 into 0.08 into 5 by 12. This comes out to 1500, and 1500 into 434 amounts to 651,000, and option 4 is the correct answer. Now, number of laptops sold of brand H of April is approximately what portion of the number of laptops sold of brand H during September? So, going with the same working, we can have the answer. We can find it for April, we can find it for September for brand H, and we can have the percentage of both the things. So the correct answer would be option number 3, 130. Then last question for this DI is, what is the ratio of the number of laptops sold of brand D during April to those sold during September of the same brand? So when we'll find the answer, we'll get 119 is to 135, as it would be 3570 for April, and for September it would be 4050. So this is the same ratio as 119.135. Now question number 36. Which one of the following coordinates promotes and funds research activities of all the social sciences discipline? So the correct answer here is ICSSR New Delhi, which is option number 3. Question 37. Which of the following disasters belong to the category of nuclear disasters? Now all of these are disasters, but only the nuclear disaster one have to be the answers. Now Fukushima disaster is a nuclear disaster. BPAR is the nuclear disaster. Three Mile Island incident is the nuclear disaster. But Love Canal disaster is not a nuclear disaster. So option first is the correct, which constitutes A, B and C. Now we have question number 38. Most of the member countries in international solar alliances are located between the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn, which is true. Statement 2, Japan is a member country of the International Solar Alliance. Recently, it has been a member of International Solar Alliance. So this is also true. So both the statements here given are true. Option number 3 is the correct answer. Now we have question number 39, that MDG's goals adopted by UN. What does it constitute now? Millennium Development Goals. So eradicate extreme poverty and hunger. Yes. Improve maternal health. Yes. Responsible consumption and production. No. And reduce child mortality. Yes. So the answer would be A, B and D. So the correct option is option number 3. Question 40. Assertion given here is nighttime temperature in the central parts of a city are generally higher than those over the surrounding rural areas. Reason given is radiation loss over the urban areas are less than that over the rural areas. So the reason here given is the correct explanation for the assertion that nighttime temperature in central parts of city are generally higher. So option number 1 is the correct answer. Both A and R are true and R is the correct explanation of A. Now the Paris Agreement aims to limit the temperature rise in this century by how many degrees Celsius above the pre-industrial levels? So the answer correct. So the answer here is option number 2, which is 2 degrees Celsius. Now which one of the following universities is not among the first three that were established in 1857? So Calcutta, Bombay and Madras. These three universities were established in 1857 and the last university of all these was the Delhi University, which was being established. So the correct answer is here, Delhi University, which is option number 3. Now, which one of the following is an example of proprietary system software? So the answer here is Microsoft Windows. 44 question, Jatin's laptop has a LCD screen. So what is the acronym for LCD? That is liquid crystal display. You can subscribe to our channel for more videos. You'll definitely find them beneficial. Now next question, question number 45. So a computer network which is used within a building is called a LAN. That is a computer question which was taught in some 6th or 7th standard. Then question 46, Gyanvani launched by IGNU to cover the educational needs of India refers to. So IGNU has initiated this Gyanvani channel. It is a basically educational FM radio network to help those people, to help the students. IGNU is basically an open university, so it is a great initiative by it. So option number 2, which is the educational FM radio network, is the correct answer. 47, with respect to computers, which one of the following best describe phishing? So phishing is basically an attempt to acquire sensitive information for malicious reasons by mass quadring as a trust as a trustworthy entity. So option number 4 is the correct answer. 48th question, a special focus on the problems of examination system of India formed a part of which one of the following reports? So according to NTA, option number 4, which is the report on standards of university education UGC 1965, is the correct answer. Question 49, why would BCC be used in an email? So email is a day-to-day part of a day-to-day life. So we know that BCC is there, CC is there, CC is carbon copy and BCC is basically, it is used for, that allows a sender of a message to conceal the recipient entered in the BCC field from the other recipient. So option number 3 is the correct answer. Last question for this paper 1 is 50th. In which of the following ancient Indian universities, the cultures and civilizations of Tibet was built mainly through the writings of the scholar? So Vikramshila is the correct answer here. So with this, we have completed paper one, which is the general paper. There is no subject specific questions here. And everyone could solve this paper one with great understanding, with logics, with reasonings, if you have good reasonings. You can subscribe to our channel and you'll find more videos there, which will definitely be beneficial for you all. Thank you.